Secret ban out the Drow and the Oracle and pick up Ogre Magi and the Marana. Liquid, no Shadow Demon, no Wisp this time, and they will pick up Elder Titan Void. That awesome combo we love to see.
Yeah, the cookie cutter combo, just so easy to get that split going down the Void Chronosphere, of course. So really easy execution for Liquid. The Ogre Magi Marana, a little surprised to see that early. But we have seen Ogre Magi just be extremely good at securing mid lane. I think that's one of his best strengths, is that he's so tanky, he can just stand on the high ground protecting his mid laner. It's kind of impossible to go and get a nice gank off. And at the same time, he is very threatening with that ignite. And Secret looked really happy. Look at Puppy. He's got a smile on his face. First time I've seen them smile.
Yeah, it's been a very mixed set of emotions for this Secret team, especially from yesterday into today. And, well, you can say the same for Liquid. Liquid, I mean, if they do happen to lose this game, we already talked about the consequences, but they will also be looking at a shutout day on their end, 0-4. So, who'd have thunk, man? Secret and Liquid being down in this kind of a position. But nonetheless, as we progress here, we look to see how they want to evolve the lineups here. Second phase bans. I mean, Huskar had been banned every game up to this point. I imagine it is something kind of in the back of the mind for these captains.
I definitely think that it is. You can't really let go of it. It's had too much of an impact in the first day of the group stage and in the second day, and it's still just there as an option, right?
Both these teams play it.
Yeah, and often. There we go. Puppy got to ban it out. Does not want to deal with that. I think it's a smart choice. They didn't have much success with it lately, and they also lost against it a few times, so better to just get rid of it at this point.
Well, let's see, for Liquid, though, what would be what they consider their possibly biggest threat here. I wonder if Lone Druid is anything they feel could be a problem. I haven't seen it, seen Secret run it a lot, but we've been seeing some success with it paired together with the Ogre.
Yeah, the Bloodlusted Lone Druid is really strong, but it really doesn't feel like something Secret will do. I don't think so. Bulba does not play that type of hero on the offlane, it feels like. And for Envy and Arteezy, you look to much more flashier heroes than a Lone Druid.
So if they wanted to get something Bulba is used to seeing here, it's been known for him to do a lot of Darkseer. He's done Tidehunter from time to time.
Slardar, Nyx, Axe is still in the pool. He, you know, loves to play a lot of different heroes, actually. He has a pretty wide range of heroes. Even the Sand King is still there. So I think Bulba's hero is still going to be easy to snag up. You don't have to go for it now unless you want to hide your different heroes for, of course, Piladai and RTZ or Envy, whoever is going to be playing the Marana and who won't.
Yeah, that's true. I don't know how much Secret value at this point to hold on to a more of a mysterious kind of a strategy or kind of showing their hand or not. I know Puppy likes to hold a bit of secrecy. Works with the name, I guess.
Definitely. You had to go there.
I did that. I did.
All right.
But still,
I feel that it's curious what they want to approach the Elder Titan and Void with. Both those heroes are quite susceptible to silences, I feel, and there are some options that you can go for, but I haven't seen Secret play the likes of Puck or Silencer Support
they
or Skywrath.
They used to go for Disruptor often, but they kind of fallen away from that a bit.
They gave up on that idea. A lot of other teams are still running it, and some of them with really good success as well. Disruptor is a strong support this patch, but it seems Secret don't really like it as much anymore. I think it would fit really good against Void, and it also is pretty decent against Elder Titan. You can, in fact, cancel his stomp from super far away by just glimpsing him if you're fast enough.
They will opt for the Timber Saw, a trusty pick for pretty much every team here in the tournament.
Yep.
And they snag it up in their second phase first.
It's come to the point where Timber Saw feels like a very reliable hero. Every time you see it, it's going to have a good impact. We saw earlier today S4 on his Timber Saw. He got shut down in the early game, 0-4-0 on Timber Saw, and then made a massive comeback.
Yeah.
And just had an absolute amazing performance.
That kind of snowball, crowd-pleasing hero.
He is.
For Liquid, focus now on something to kind of deal with the Timber Saw? They have been a team known to pick up something like Cottle from time to time.
I feel this just baits Skywrath pick. I'm not sure if bait might be the right word, because
it just
fits so well with your own lineup as well.
That's true.
When you have one of those moments where a hero synergizes with you and counters the opponent, it's normally a really golden pick. But question is, do they want to play it? They could also go towards the likes of Nyx, very good against Timber Saw. You can just spike Carapace, run next to the Timber Saw, and when the Timber chains away next time, you just stun him. Impel follows up.
Very
easy
true.
Easy to kill.
Very, very true. would, though.
Timber will have the issue of time dilation, though. That is the thing that we haven't really mentioned. And time dilation messes with Timber so much that you sort of have to buy a Yule Scepter or a Lotus Orb just because of Void.
Yeah, and typically has been the former, the latter. Lotus Orb has been a more popular grab for Timber. I mean, obviously, probably here too. I mean, you get the armor benefit going against the Elder Titan. I'd imagine that seems to be the sweeter choice.
For sure. And wow, Lifestealer coming in.
Lifestealer is the pick here for Liquid.
That is a curious pickup, I feel.
A strength core directly into the Timber Saw. I mean, at first I'm kind of like, whoa, but is there something we're missing here?
I just think he's pretty good against the Mirana and Ogre Magi in terms of. He infests into Faceless Void, maybe, or if they're going to pick up the lives of a Ricky or something to get close and personal, he can really shred down on them pretty quickly. The Elder Titan to remove the armor from even Ogre, they would melt very quickly to a Lifestealer.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't love Lifestealer against Timbersaw. I feel like it can work, but it's not great.
Something we got to see from Alliance earlier today, the Lich comes out now. Some teams do occasionally reach for this as a possible option to sub in some extra armor when opposing, you know, the Elder Titan here. And it was a certain Ice Armor that happened to pretty much save the whole game as they were able to kind of get it on
Spoilers!
The Ancient.
I haven't watched it yet.
I heard from a little birdie that Ice Armor was a big factor in that game. All right.
I will have a look at that replay later, as we've been busy with our own day as well, of course. But Lich is a pretty nice pickup here as Lifestealer and Faceless Void. All they really bring is physical damage, apart from the infest damage, of course. And I think this is going to be a great answer to Elder Titan. Wow, Alchemist. They're just pumping up melee heroes. Look at this.
Yeah, this
Team Liquid is like, we are going to pick no range hero at all.
Bash Brothers, Bruisers. What are you going to do about it, little baby Rage? Huh? We're going to beat the hell out of you.
Don't say that. He looks so...
He's like, please, I'm just so innocent. I'm a child.
He looks really innocent. There's no baby rage going on. He just wants to win some Dota. It's been a hard few days.
You know, contemplating, of course, anticipating what... the modes are going to be for them now as they see that they're going to have to go against this Alchemist kind of a game, which I know some players have been pretty vocal about. Not always the biggest fans about having to approach a game and know that you have to keep tabs on someone like that.
Yeah, we'll see what they do here. He's definitely reacting to this Alchemist pick and being a little bit surprised. I can't really blame him. I wonder what they're going to go for. I just feel Team Liquid put themselves in a weird spot having four melee heroes against a Lich. Remaining. That Chain Frost is going to have the potential to bounce a lot.
When you get a techie is when they have all melee heroes, am I right?
I mean, I have a hard time. Not techie actually shit against everything, but I have a hard time making sense out of the triple strength where they pick two of the strength heroes after the Timbersaw.
Yeah.
Even though Rage, yes, you mitigate the damage for that duration, but if you ever get caught out by a stun or anything, Timbersaw just shreds you to pieces. This is so weird from Liquid. Really an unorthodox type of drafting.
It's Kuro, too, and it's like, we know he knows what he's doing.
And before he picks one more strength hero.
Yeah, right?
10 seconds remaining. I'll just leave.
No secret. I think it's going to be the line they ban that out. Pick. Liquid rid of that Sand King that Bulba has made some waves on earlier. And we'll have to see now what that other more selfless support is going to be here for their team.
Yeah, thinking about it a little bit, they're looking for the... Remaining. It's the Earth Spirit. They want a strength melee support. He's here.
Oh,
go for it.
Lord have mercy, please, no.
Go for more melee. Okay.
Ooh, Rubik.
That is a Team nice little pick. It's been a while since we got to see a Rubik as well, I feel. Me and you, Dakota.
Yeah. Yeah, very true. It's nice. He has that natural null field, which has been buffed in recent history. I know it's not the craziest thing to brag about, but it will be some nice natural resistance when you're going against something like the Lich, of course, Mirana, Ogre, and company.
And they got two really great players as well. Both Kuroki, of course, notorious on it.
Okay, God?
Yeah. And Jerick's also a big fan of playing it. I'm thinking Kuro is going to play it. If Jerick's does as well, then I know he's also a very good Rubik player.
Final pick from Secret. It's the Envy Terrorblade, Waga. We are going to be in for a Terrorblade versus Alchemist final game.
Man, Terrorblade's going to be great against all those melees, too. Whenever he drops the Reflection, it's going to hit so many people. The value on this slow is going to be really good. And if Alchemist gets a Radiance, that's also going to... against them.
Is there anything to say, though, for Liquid's lineup where it does feel like they need time to build up? Because it does seem pretty greedy. Or do you think they have the capability of being able to take fights and skirmishes early on? Because I look at Secret's lineup, and I could see an Ogre moving around, causing some trouble. I could see Mirana making some movements, too. Even Liquid,
Liquid are definitely greedy, and they do not have very good answers to Terrorblade. I think this Terrorblade was a great last pickup. All the armor he has, with the Frost armor as well, and then the Illusion army that there's really not that much against. Acid Spray, Fade Bolt, and the Elder Titan spells. That's really all you have. And indeed, it's going to be Jerax on the Rubick.
All right. We get out and underway here. We'll fly through some of the introductions as we get the early TP for Kuro to get some warding advantage in the lane. To remind everyone what's at cost here for this final game of the group stage, Liquid need this win to go into a tiebreaker situation against MVP, where they will battle it out for an upper bracket spot, the last upper bracket spot. But if Liquid are to lose this game, then we have no tiebreakers. And Secret and Liquid just both hold hands in the lower bracket.
Yeah, Secret took their first game. That was really crucial for them, getting that win. They need the 2-0. Really
important
for them.
Full five-man smoke movement from Secret already. Heading up and around Matumaman, spinning around in circles, spinning and spinning and spinning, but he doesn't know his trouble's approaching right from behind.
Yeah, getting closer. He walks into them.
Sees it now. The Ignite's going to fly out. Pubby should be able to move in. Hasn't leveled anything up yet because
the
you know you want to keep sacrifice, Bulba. But... can they line up the shot? The arrow flies. Oh, he sidesteps it right there at the last second.
And everyone gives up immediately. It's
yeah.
Like, you missed. You missed it.
You missed, Bulba. In case you didn't know, you missed. Good luck
he
next
tried,
time.
Man.
Yeah, he did a good job. He tried to line it over the tree so it kind of come in at a blind angle. But Matumaman was clicking quick and his trigger finger was ready to sidestep and he got it out. So
interesting to see Bulba playing the Mirana as well in this
yeah.
game. Every time that Secret has played the Mirana previously in this TI, it's been on Envy and Arteezy. They just used it a lot. They've been drafting it a lot. And this time got to pick it up on the offlaner.
Yeah, I'm curious.
Mind control with
yeah.
the bull.
I'm looking up here, I'm like, mind control, he's yellow, but he's on Dire side. What am I looking at here? But he's actually taking the creeps on a conga line adventure elsewhere, it appears.
Yeah,
is he going to do that strat? We saw that strat earlier when he brought to the mid lane.
Yeah, the TNC thing, I don't think he's going to do that.
TNC had
there was the moment
wave.
Where TNC's offlaner brought a full creep wave on level 1 to Cuckoo on the Storm mid. Yes, it was strange, but it wasn't necessarily bad. I think it's better what he's doing now, though, on mind control, just going to farm away. Safely.
I don't think Liquid's ready for that strat yet, is
no.
the thing. So.
Maybe TI 7.
Maybe TI 7. They head their way back up and over, and we'll go right back into work here, and we're going to have to see, because based on paper, it does look pretty damn promising for Secret. But I wonder if, yeah, if the Bulba Mirana, if it was something that they were intending on doing from the get-go, or if it's something they just had to kind of pull out as an audible or not. But nonetheless, it's paired together with Puppy's Lich, and in the meantime, Bulba's going to be content and just finding some easy CS.
Yeah, he's going to be happy down here with the help of Puppy, of course, getting those denies out on the range creeps. Going to make it a little bit hard for this lifestealer of Matumaman to get a lot of farm. It's never fun to lane against a Lich like this.
Do you know what is the percent of XP that range creep holds from the whole wave? It's something pretty high. I don't mean to put you on the spot for knowing the exact number, but...
I think it holds roughly 45% or 40% of the total experience.
Yeah.
I think it's something like that.
It's he pops a big XP bomb right there, so if he's able to remove that from the field, that is rough for Liquid. And Matumaman is going to have to... like it's like nearly two waves to make up for it, so... tough times, but and now the wave moving far forward, Secret are going to be very happy that it's pulled all the way back under the tower.
Exactly, that's the effect that you get from a Lich. You can just safely farm under your tower for such a big part of the laning stage.
And then what Bulba does is he goes off to the camp, farms out on his own, and lets Puppy take all
oh
the
God.
Solo XP too.
Pyladai threatening his ogre brother on the mid lane. He's like, come here, I just want to punch you.
The father doesn't want any of it, turns
nope.
the corner and walks back and away, and Pi will just kind of continue his passing here. And around the corner and come back again, possibly. Really trying to be a pain in the arse right here for Fateh. And it forces him back. I mean, he's not going to be involved at all, and Envy just gets all the free farm in the mid lane here. He's 12-3 to Alk 7-0. Doubling up now.
Yeah, doing really well. And yeah, just double checked this. You made me feel bad not knowing straight off, but it's 90 experience, of course, for the range creep. And
90? 9-0?
90 experience per range creep and 45 per melee creep. So it's 135 versus 90.
Wow.
It's a big chunk of experience being removed. And it's not just that. It goes towards the Lich as well.
Yep.
He's getting experience for every deny he does. Nasty little mechanic.
Fun pub hero for newer support players if they want someone that's pretty autopilot. I think Lich is probably one of my top candidates to recommend. But here, Matama Man will kind of make the most of the situation as it is, and Jerix has made his own rotation to kind of assist Fata, it looks like, in the meantime, because Pilot Die continues to hang around.
I love Pilot Die. He's doing exactly what we mentioned in the draft. He can just sit on the high ground. No one can do anything to him because he's an ogre, and yeah, you don't really mess with him. Just run wherever he wants to, kind of control some runes, protect some ganks.
Yep. Now, what about for this top lane matchup, though? Arteezy's Timber taking a Mind Control's Faceless Void here.
It's sort of a wash. I think both of them should be able to farm really well. And I don't know. I guess you're happy if you want to get momentum on Arteezy. Nothing is stopping him from getting a very good Bloodstone timing. At the same time, a farmed Void from this position, he's going to be more of the carry than the Lifestealer at the rate that the game is going, especially with that solo experience being level 5 already.
Yeah. Void just getting so much. Could look to put a Chrono to work right away here, and you know, it is a greedy lineup overall from Liquid, but that would be a tool to come online sooner and maybe open up some options for them going the offensive. Speaking of which, they seem to have caught out a puppy Lich here. Hit him up with a stomp, but that may be the end of it. Or not. Jerix happens to TP in, smacks him in the face with a Fade Bolt, pulls him back with the Telekinesis, and they're going to be able to get the burst. Curl picks up that kill and picks up the first blood for Team Liquid.
Yeah, clutch little TP there, and Puppy gets the note that he's not an ogre. He will die.
He is a frail, tiny, undead-looking, chilly skeleton, man.
Yeah, he just wants to sit on a lane. You don't really want to move around too much like this. Even though he has a ward on him, it's really just better if they can try and let Pilot Eye do the dirty work in the beginning, and he just makes sure the bottom lane is auto one. As a Lich, you want to avoid moving as much as possible.
And he will sit tight back at this bottom lane, joining Pulba in the meantime as he continues to farm up nicely on his Mirana, trying to match up at least as best as possible with Mind Control, continues to kind of have his one-on-one spree. But, you know, as expected, Liquid are kind of with their hands tied to be more reactionary than more pro-action.
And we might see the same thing again as DC were doing in one of the games yesterday, where this top lane Timbersaw is just going to free farm a lot in the early game, and then he can switch down to bottom lane and say, hello, Lifestealer, I am level 7 or 8, you know, on the Timbersaw, and he can just take over that lane. So I'm definitely expecting Bulba to be making a switch top and Timbersaw to making a switch bottom eventually. It's just a matter of when are they going to do this switch.
And Matama Man having to, for the most part, split up the lane between the two others. You know, he's been lagging a little bit in the XP, but not doing too shabby, actually. I mean, 5 at a little over 5 minutes in for being in what felt like a natural tri-lane. Not too shabby.
And Lifestealer is pretty self-sufficient on the lane here. He can take care of himself in terms of HP for the most part.
Mm-hmm.
But Bulba is trying to harass him whenever, and he has Mana Boots already on this Mirana, so they want to give some harass here.
Oh, okay, here they come. Pilai Dai, bottom lane, joins up his comrades and hopes to make it a go, but Kuro is out the back door. We'll drop out the Spirit instead. So his team moves and shifts, but Fata will spot this one as the Spirit continues to stalk him a bit.
They're just looking for Fata and his farm in the jungle here. Gonna drop down a ward, and now, of course, coming to contest is Bulba.
Yeah, don't want this Alchemist to kind of continue to bring in a bunch of money here on the side. Lift, throw back on Pi. Bulba, he's going to find the shot. He will, when it's set up with a Fire Blast, makes it a lot easier. You move in with the Ignite and the Star Storm, and that's going to easily do the job. Jerix will fall, and Secret will match things up evenly, 1-1.
Yeah, that was a lot of time committed, though, for core Mirana to walk into the jungle here. And, of course, Lifestealer have been farming up a lot. Going to hit level 6 now and trying to infest to get some HP back. And he'll be full.
Pretty nice. Arrow to snipe down a creep from Bulba.
This is very concerning, though. We haven't really mentioned too much, but Envy, 49 for 27. He's been shutting this mid lane down really hard.
Yeah, he's going crazy here. And Fata's trying to make up for it by doing some farm on the side and in hopes to move and be a part of some of this bounty rune action, but it has really been all Envy. With the influence that Pi has made in the early mid lane too, it's very, very difficult.
It's just that he doesn't take any damage at all from the acid spray. He has, right now, 21 armor on this Terrorblade. He's getting the frost armor from his teammates, and then he's a Terrorblade. That also helps. Bada just has to try and find something on the side, really. But he's maxing Greeble's greed.
He's making a stack, and Pi's like, you making a stack? No, you're not.
Oh, but he doesn't really want to tank it, so he broke it.
Okay, it did end up breaking. But that has got to be a big griefing here. Fata, when he's like, I'm just trying to find a home and a place to kind of work out, and Envy's just going to end up being a problem brewing here in the back lines of Secret.
Seems to always be that way when you play Alchemist. People just don't want to let you farm. Really strange how that works out.
If they let him farm, I think they end up losing. That's usually what happens. So maybe you stop that happening.
And here's Pilot Eye saying hi to
stop that. I don't want to lose. I'm going to stop you farming.
Yeah. I will just say hi to you. But it's a little bit deep. He doesn't want to stick around there because Mind Control's swinging in, and he saw that with his ward, so definitely don't want to get Chronosphered that far away from your friends.
How much kill potential does Liquid have with this Chrono now?
Quite a bit, in fact. I think it's all coming down to whether Lifesteer is able to walk in and kill stuff with his right fixed as well. Level 3 Rage. He hits pretty hard.
Oh, top lane. Kuro TP's up there. RTZ tries to jump at him a bit, but doesn't quite catch him.
Yeah, and RTZ is, of course, fully free farmed. The two farmer brothers of Secret, right? RTZ and Envy.
Yep.
They're having a good day, both of them.
And I don't know if one Matamaman Lifestealer is going to be enough to handle both of them while Fata tries to play a bit of catch-up.
It's hard when you're laning against the Lich as well. How are you really going to carry against that? It's more about the Void and about the Alchemists. They all need to get something.
It really feels like a three-lane success right now for Secret as things are going.
Ooh, Kuroki. Are they going to go on him?
Well, they're thinking about it here. Puppy and Pi smoked up, supports in arms here, looking to put some hate on maybe a fellow teammate, or a former teammate, rather.
Yeah.
I think they could do it.
He deserves it. Let's go, buddies.
They're thinking about it. There they go. And Ignite's going to be flying out first. Then they get him with the Fire Blast. Timber Chain's on forward. Puppy hits him with the Frost Nova. And then RTZ comes in and slices them all up and serves them up for lunch.
Yeah, he'll get that kill. And Envy now making a switch for top lane. He's going to say hi to this tower. Terrorblade.
It will not be a very long greeting because in that form, being that big, I mean, Bloodlust too. Look at that thing.
Bloodlust, Ice Armor.
Looks like it belongs in World of Warcraft. It's ridiculous. He's huge.
He is quite massive.
They get tier one, they walk on out. Things looking very, very good for Secret at the start of this one.
And in fact, Pilot Eye gets to recover some experience as well in the mid lane here. There's no mid laner to take the experience. Okay, that's time for Ogre.
Yeah, pushes him closer to being able to get that level 6, get that multicast to Gummon.
Yeah.
And pump out some more points into Bloodlust, I'm sure, too.
Of course, the max Bloodlust into max Ignites, the same build that everyone's really doing on Ogre.
Yep.
Just about making your course get that much stronger.
Nice Rock, very nice, and making a discount in the price of that Bloodlust has certainly changed up the build a bit.
Yeah, it's being used a lot. The 50 mana cost is so easy to just keep spamming, and we might see a little bit of a smoke? No, a smoke movement here by Secret, just grouping up a little bit.
Mind Control is Invis hanging around this mid lane. A couple Envy Terrorblades here. Approach, finally the real one shows himself, and there's going to be the Chrono. Quick Moonlight Shadow does fly out. Do they have the detection? It might not be necessary. They get the stop, and a quick Sunder saps the life right back from Kuro. And Envy, though, is still in trouble, trying to run back in the way, gets hit with a Fable, and then they make their move. Mind Control will pick up the last hit. Arrow flies, but only catches a creep. Secret will quickly drop two.
The fact that they killed him through the Sunder to full HP was pretty impressive. They got a lot of damage when they closed down on someone like that. It's the... just speaks about how effective Liquid can be. That was before they even get that many items. They did have the double armlet though. It's a bit.
Ooh, guys here. He's looking to go right for the Elder Titan. Can he take out the blue cow? He's going for it. He got it. Timber Chain's right on through. Matamaman's here now. TZ stunned up, but he gets what he needs and he gets out.
Yeah, Jarek's with a pretty good steal as well, getting the Timber Chain for Rubick. Can definitely help set up some ganks. That's a very good mobility spell right there for Rubick.
Oh, absolutely.
And
insta-cast, sure.
Pretty much got his money for Arcane Boots as well. Bottom tower being pressured a lot here by Bulba.
So is top two, though. I mean, Mind Control's knocking away at this tier one.
Yep.
So it looks like it could be a trade.
And I think Secret, they just want to get the tower done, the tower stuff done, so that they can fall back and farm up their ancients, of course. Fada is stacking and farming ancients as well as the Alchemist. Oh,
Mind Control TP away. A little bit, but yeah, Time Walk TP, and TZ will have nothing to say in the matter, but he will save his tier 1 for now.
That will be just fine. That is, in fact, a 5 stack on the Dire Ancient, so there's a lot of money to clear out.
Curl is hit with an Ignite and a Fire Blast, and Puffy says, let's go for the chain arrow. Just off the mark, Curl very low, but they stole the chain and sent it right back their way. What a play from Jarex.
I told you, man, watch out for his Rubik. He's a sneaky one.
He crept right in there and just stole that under the nose of Secret and sent it right back in their face.
Well, it really helped for him as well. He could just get that close, get early with that Chain Frost as he had the Timber Chain to get close as well. He really set this up for himself. And Secret overestimate their potential. Didn't even get the kill as well. Kuroki just walked away.
Arrow almost got him, but was not quite enough. Highlight die, I mean, he was the one to lead it off, but with just the casual one level of Fire Blast as we expect it, he doesn't really offer too much burst at the moment, so.
And again, this is a little bit reminding me about the previous game. You said that it was a little bit cautious from Liquid to Secret and the other way around as well. Yes, that was a very aggressive move by the supports, but both these teams are kind of focusing on themselves the most.
Yeah.
One little smoke coming out here again, though, from Secret. Just trying to create space, maybe, as the Terrorblade could go for the stack. Doesn't that meta, though?
That Rubik still also holds the Chain Frost, and he could nurse it all the way till it's off cooldown to have it again for a future fight, but...
He could, unless his Alchemist gets Dolva on the mid lane.
Yeah, that's the thing, is that a fight could be coming to him before he would like, in the form of a movement from behind, but Liquid is up and on the other side too here, Waga. So we could see a clash from both fronts. Actually, it's already Liquid trying to make a move, maybe for Bulba. Bulba going to be forced to pull out the Moonlight Shadow.
Yeah, with the Infested Void, that's pretty powerful as well.
Yep.
They're going in, but just illusions. Oh, they've been spotted. The Sentry Ward on mid. They see them.
Okay, Arteezy's running forward. Are Liquid going to be ready for this? They look to just totally pull back.
Yeah, they know exactly what's coming. They're just going to run away. Good wards down by Liquid.
This means that they could come in from a different angle here, and a Secret get a bit too careless in the mid lane. Could get caught, potentially from behind. Mind Control looking for the setup, makes his move, they pop it out, and they look to go for Pi. Meanwhile, the rest of company, including Fatakuro and Jarex, look to make a move possible for Arteezy, but no, it's Arteezy actually, who turns around and shreds the Fata. Mind Control gets a nice three-man connection, and they dish out the offensive Chain Frost between the three, but they quickly dealt the split and avoid the trouble. A new Chain Frost flies out, this one from Puppy, but it does not do a whole lot of work. Meanwhile, Jarex gets hit with a Timber Chain and walks away with one of his own, and that's all going to be just for the tier one. Fata's the only one to drop after everything is said and done.
Yeah, just one hero going down, and Envy here moving in for the Ancient. Stealing this away from the Alchemist is a big dent.
Stomps there from Kuro, hoping to save as much of money as he can.
Yeah, a little bit scared of the jump, of course. Man, just these team fights before you have time dilation, though, is really, really hard to take. Mind Control really needs one point in it.
And he needs to time walk away there as he gets hit with a couple of shots Jarex coming in. Jarex needs one more shot. Arteezy gets the Timber Chain.
Goes down, and that's a second Bloodstone charge added to this full fresh Bloodstone.
Yep. He charges now. He picks it up, and well, he gets some blood right on it. And with that, Secret takes some momentum right back. They've been very back and forth to this point, but
they don't have meta, so I think they're going to just back out and take it a little bit easy. They have so much to recover and fall back on as well. But doesn't mean that the Timber Saw and the Ogre Magi have to fall back. They can keep playing like this, enemy territory.
Yeah, let some of the others continue the farm. I know Bulba would love to finish off his Agnum Scepter. He's just one component away from that. While on the other side, Mind Control, who's actually spotted out Puppy, hits him with a first hit bash.
Oh my
bash, get one more, because, you know, why not? Oh, he's not going to get it, though.
He was thinking about jumping after him, but that would be a mistake.
He's top tank. Gone. He's under attack.
Didn't have the Chain Frost ready as well to do the
cancel, yeah.
Cancel on the stun.
So, just Mind Control letting Secret know that he's hanging out on their turf and will step out and away. And Liquid back into the grind, but still not in the position they were hoping to be in here, Waga. As any casual Alchemist game, we always expect to see them there at the top of the net worth with a bar that seems far and hard to catch up with. In this case, he's third in net worth and barely etching his way up to second.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. You always see it, of course, the...
Matama in top lane's in some possible trouble here. Arteezy has been 1v1-ing him, and then Matama Man actually turns it back after he pops out the Rage.
Hey, he's going to get away just fine on Arteezy, but a lot of rotations were forced to try and catch him.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Puppy under the back end of that Moonlight Shadow.
Bulba as well, looking for Fata.
Oh, Pops out the Chain Frost between the creeps. Hits him twice. Fata is able to get off the stun.
Chrono.
Puts it on the Bulba. Chrono going to be committed for the Puffy support here. Bulba steps in to try to help out. Maybe the end of it here.
Yeah, not much more going to happen. A lot of spells being used, but nothing really dying.
Chrono for not killing a Lich.
Yeah, meanwhile, though, look at Envy. He's cleared up the entire 5-stack on the Ancients. That's a ton of money going his way.
2,200 gold. He already has his Dragonlance. He already has his Yasha. He is becoming a tyrant.
Really is. And we all know what Terrible is like when he gets some farm.
Yeah.
They don't have the best heroes to clear his illusions as well.
Hero migrating around this mid lane. Walked through a sentry, but I don't think the vision was there by Secret to spot him.
No, not quite, I believe.
So he just moves on through and all the way over to Yonder. But
probably not going to find much more. Just going to scout out the Roshan here and see that he's up and well, doing just fine. No one killing him just yet. Bulba has the full Aghanim Scepter now on the Murano, though. Secret want to take a fight with us.
Secret and their item progression is just looking so damn wonderful. I can't help but fear for Liquid at this moment, Waga, and what they're going to have to do.
Yeah.
And they have to wait longer, too, because they already had committed that Chrono for that attempted kill, I suppose, onto the Lich. So
they are close to a Desolator on Lifestealer. I think that's going to be one of their big timings right now, especially with the Vladimir's they have completed on the Void. That's going to mean he's kind of a monster. But other than that, they just need the Radiance. 1,000 gold away. Alchemist needs to keep farming a little bit more.
Yeah, and then, you know, the next step after that, you get the Manta, you get the Octarine Core.
He's not done just yet,
is he? He's got lots of steps ahead of him in order to even help be able to kind of relieve the pressure. But if Secret have any say in the matter, they're going to want to bulk up and make a push before he can even get that close.
I definitely believe so.
I mean, what do you think about the comparison timings? I know given that Envy has been getting much, much more farm this game in particular as opposed to Fata, but is it typical for the Terrorblade to be able to come online this much sooner than the Alchemist?
I just think Alchemist didn't have the easiest time mid. It was just the Ogre Magi, the pressure it was under, and Terrorblade does outlast hit the Alchemist really hard. Alchemist doesn't have the best last hit to begin with, and the Acid Spray normally keeps him safe so he can last it, but Terrorblade starts with 10 armor. He does not care about that physical damage.
And now Secret are looking to make a move for the tier 2. Liquid are nearby, but really don't have too much to say in the matter. In fact, they might need to just get the hell back to avoid trouble from Arteezy here. And they will pull off. That's tier 2 going down. Liquid only hold on to two more towers on the outskirts here before they're stuck possibly in the dark. Making the most of the map elsewhere, though, is Matama Men trying to at least split the pressure and delay things out as much as possible for himself or the Alk to farm up. But Secret, they're just going down that checklist, man.
Oh, yeah.
By the time we get to the bottom part says win the game. So
yeah, all their cores are really coming online nicely. It kind of feels like it's a 3-core versus 2-core kind of matchup as well, where the Void just doesn't have enough farm right now. He's been going for a lot of these kill attempts and they didn't work out. Oh, Bulba. Looking for Kuro, but didn't really connect enough.
And it looks like they'll take this moment to move in for the Rogue. Secret figure that if Liquid aren't comfortable yet taking a fight, and their best chance would maybe a fight coming to them, but I wager they'll be able to do this, and Liquid are... Well, they're
the
going to go
rune.
Elsewhere. Yeah, we'll go elsewhere. And yeah, how nice. A DD rune once again right by that Rosh Pit certainly makes things a lot easier.
To be fair,
it?
Liquid did get that in the first game of the series as well. They had the DD served right in front of them with the instant Rosh respawn.
That's right.
This time it's going to be Secret getting the nice DD Rosh.
And it's going to be Arteezy who picks it up. He also recently did grab that Lotus Orb too. So in addition to obviously being able to purge off whatever's necessary, he gets the armor bonus to match up against the Elder Titan.
I feel it's a great item this game for sure.
Yeah, wonderful value pickup.
I mean, there's even a possibility of Jerax maybe messing up with a Lich ulti or something like that. That's just a possibility for devastation if that was to happen. And they have a smoke now on the mid lane, Secret, but it's just the two supports. I think they need to pair up with Bulba if they want to fight. And he's like, I just need a little bit of money for Blink, guys. We'll see if they're going to go or not.
Yeah, because
thinking about it.
They don't have to worry about too much elsewhere here. Liquid's farming their own way up in this top lane, but Arteezy is happy to guard out and keep these lanes pushed off. Secret don't need too much resources at the moment to kind of fend off Liquid with where they are.
Well, even if they were to go on Arteezy right now as well, he has that Aegis, so they can't really commit that. Oh, mind control.
They actually commit in with the Moonlight Shadows. They spotted out the Faceless Void. He's going to make a valiant jump over to the other side, but look who's waiting for him. Oh, the mighty Dark Lord. But he is get caught under the Chrono, a a defensive one from Mind Control as he retreats back and out. While on the other side, Kuro lays down the Earth Spinner. A response is going to be the Chain Frost onto Jerix, who will be taken out first.
Very good kill in the end there for them. A lot of spells being used, though. But with the Chrono and the Earth Spinner gone, I think this is pushing time.
And here comes the big behemoth. He begins to go to work now on the Tier 2 and Liquid. Face being in the lower bracket if they can't slow the momentum here from Secret.
Secret just really going for it, and they cannot take the fight outside of the base. Right now, you just gotta keep farming. If you look to Matumba Man, he knows what's up. Just keep farming the creeps.
Just farm and farm and just know that the inevitable could be coming where you're gonna have to high ground defend. You're gonna want as many tools as possible to work with here.
All the items you can get, really.
All of the items. Anything. And one more tier 2 to work with there in the top lane.
Travel for TZ now on his Timbersaw, looking really set as well. 12,800 gold on the Terrorblade, 12,000 on the Timbersaw. Alchemist being behind in net worth to any hero is never a good thing.
No.
Being behind two enemies is not a good sign.
No, it is not. Envy's next item grab is actually going to be a Diffusal Blade now. So more purge capabilities, more just raw damage for him, and also that Blink Dagger on Bulba also going to be snagged up here. More good things coming their way. Back at mid lane, we have Arteezy casually keeping the pressure on Liquid.
Yeah, they're just forcing them to play from their base or close to the towers at all times while Secret are making more use of the map. Envy farming Ancients, they have Bulba clearing creep waves. It just makes them get more and more money flowing in. And that's why you see the net worth, it just keeps going their way.
The slow starve. Secret have applied this kind of pressure on many teams in the past. Feel kind of right at home being in this position.
It has to be a pretty good feeling as well after so many tough games to have this sensation that you're in control of the game and you can keep having it your way.
Much like Burger King.
Much like that. Not that we're working with him.
Down at bottom, Bulba. You know, he's... For not having to see him play the Miranda in quite a while, he's been doing all right. I'm not as flashy as some of the other Secret members, I'd have to say, but job's done. Quick to react with the Moonlight Shadow.
Oh, yeah.
Set up, arrow. And he actually connects with this one. And a reverse Caster's Curse, possibly here, Waga. But Mind Control will be able to time walk away, but Bulba's not done yet. He actually forces out the Chrono.
Meanwhile,
Puppy goes down. Matumba Man's able to get the snipe on Little Lich there in the mid lane.
Yeah, he found two supports, and Lifesteer definitely shreds them really quick. But here comes the Cavalry.
Oh, arrow just Bounty in block front of
Arteezy.
Smell my Timbersaw ass, is all he says. He's not going to allow him to pass whatsoever, and just bulldozes right on forward into the base. He is seriously a mech right here.
Yeah, he's just chasing in. He knows he has so much armor to work with. He can't really be brought down by the towers alone. This is the push coming here from Envy. So much agility now, the defuse, but Jesus, the damage.
Arrow to fly out, it's so much work, and that is quickly going to be a tier 3. Secret know that even with a win here, it's not going to get him in the upper bracket, but it will get him into a better position for Liquid. Seeing this one go down means they go down into that lower bracket and into the scary best of one.
Yeah, nice stomp here coming in, but they can't really commit as they don't have Lifestealer. Gotta just sit back. Oh, even potential to make an aggressive play, but Secret are gonna play it safe, back out. Very good choice. They already did a lot of structural damage there.
Oh yeah. That is money in the pocket for the rest of them too.
And very intimidating seeing that Terrorblade deal that much damage in no time at all. He is getting real farmed.
And just accept the fact that when he comes back to do it again, he'll probably have another new item to make him even more scary.
Yeah, just a Scotty or something along those lines. Yeah. It's gonna be great fun.
What do Liquid do, man?
I think they need to be the ones making the aggressive moves, but they don't have the best stuff to throw into a Chronosphere. Honestly, it just comes back to they have a kind of wonky draft. I mentioned it during the drafting phase, I still feel it. This quad melee
with
not
the Chrono. It's...
Yeah, you have four melee heroes, and only one of them can actually move into the Chronosphere. The rest of them have to somehow do stuff outside of it. I don't know, man. It's not easy to execute. I want to say they should just go and gank, but I don't know who should be going and ganking. I guess the Chakram Rubik is the best damage they have right now, with the Lifestealer, of course, for the physical. But yeah, right now they just got to keep farming, I think, which is really a sad spot.
Alk finally gets his position at the top of the net worth where, you know, you hope he's at sooner and holding longer and with a much bigger difference, but he's only barely able to etch up there now thanks to the Grievous Greed.
Yeah, and he won't have enough to really stop a Terrorblade if he doesn't rack up a lot, and he needs the help from Void and Lifestealer.
Do you have to itemize appropriately? Do you get something like a Mjolnir at some point just to help with the ridiculous amount of illusions?
Mjolnir would be really good, but you don't make yourself tankier when you buy a Mjolnir as well. And these illusions hurt mid lane. Might see a goal here of a Pilot Eye sticking far back. Pilot is always... He's also started building into the Aghanims on this Ogre. Very close, in fact. He's just needing 1,050 gold.
Doesn't even want to finish out an Aether Lens. He just wants to go right for the juicy stuff, the secondary blast.
Pi knows how to play that poor life, you know, the position 6 stuff. He knows how to make the most out of very little gold.
Top lane. Are we having a trade here, Fata? Looks like he's able to TP away from the trouble of Arteezy Ball. Back at mid lane, looks like Mind Control will be able to snack up a Bounty Rune and vault back over. Ooh, don't head that way. Gotta be careful.
Liquid trying to just get some grasp on the map, but has to be careful at the same time because Bulba is just sneaking around in their jungle at all times. And if he ever lands an arrow and flies in, there's a lot of heroes that just instant die. We even saw the Void lose so much of his HP. We'll see how Liquid can crawl their way back into this game.
There is a way to crawl back. We'll have to see. It's gonna be tricky. Secret still nursing their time a bit. It looks like they're keeping tabs on the Roche pit here, looking to kind of take the safer road. You can't really blame them being a final game of the group stage.
Ryan, no, the comeback. There's only one comeback in this game. They need to pull an Aghanims to Jarex, get that 2-second cooldown on Spellsteel.
Oh, yeah.
And just carry the game.
Yep.
It's actually a 2-second cooldown even on the lowest level, so it doesn't matter what level the Rubick is, as long as he has the mana to sustain it. Oh, well. We'll see Miranda Invis popping here, see if they can go on Matumba Man. Seems to have been their target, but he's running away.
But he's running up.
Oh, he's sticking around.
Still there.
Ogre, where are you? Pi, what are you doing?
Oh, they changed their mind and just completely pull off.
Pi didn't feel it, man. He just hung back a little bit. He didn't want to walk in there. He's like, I don't have four staff and stuff. I don't want to walk there.
They're like, maybe that would have been too easy, so we'll just let him go. Pull back and away here.
It's just Secret respecting Liquid, actually, though. Mm-hmm. They know that if they make a mistake here, they could definitely lose. But Envy, now with that Assault Cuirass, he's looking really strong. The double damage again could go for a bottom tier push if he wants to, but see if Secret quickly make that choice.
Liquid currently making their own advancement. It's up on Secret's side as they migrate down and through this mid lane. But eventually they are going to have to deal with the approach from Secret. They've been waiting quite a while, but it looks like they have decided on what they want to do, and it's possibly a push down through this bottom lane. Always circling and hanging around this Roche pit, though. It looks like they could be just kind of sneaking in for that eventually.
Liquid have been spotted by the ward there by Secret. And as they don't have Timsaw right there, be a little bit careful, but he can always travel in. He's coming. All right, it seems like Quid are going to fall back a little bit.
Time though, it's time for them to kind of keep moving back and forth here, and not time to focus really on the farm at hand.
Now with the smoke, they tried to go, but I wonder if they're going to be able to catch anyone. Kuro seems to be in danger.
Okay, Kuro walks out the head and then quickly sees that there's Secret all over the place, and he goes down just as fast as he walked in. He's going to be out now for about 37 seconds without a buyback here.
Yeah, and bottom lane is available to be pushed in here as Secret. They all start moving there, apart from Envy, who's going in on mid, but
yeah,
there should be backdoor regen, and there is.
Yep.
Dota still works.
Dota does still work. Creep wave is pretty far behind, but there they make the move in.
Now it's gone, though. Bottom reach.
Glyph comes out, but it's not going to stop everything here. The firepower does continue as they make their move in.
Oh, God.
Those illusions. Is in trouble. Liquid can't stop it. Gonna be a hard hit for him to recover from, and they just gotta take it.
Yeah, and Secret can just back out and take Roshan right now. Liquid are playing very scared, but honestly, they don't have many tools to work with. I just feel they massively outdrafted themselves in this one. It looks so hard, especially as the Void went down for the initiation path. He has the Blink Dagger, and they need to put it to use now. Going for this Roshan stop with the smoke, they need to be there in time. Oh boy. It's a quick Roshan, though.
Yes, it is. They'll go right in and go to work, but okay, I guess they worry about Liquid's approach here. They smoke, they move out. Arrow gets sent.
Rune of Destiny again available. Both teams see it.
Rain scans up and around the area, but does not trigger yet. Oh, this has got to be a bit nerve-wracking. They move in, and they kind of scope that the Roche was hit a bit, but now they worry that they've just walked into a potential trap of Secret.
Yeah, they're thinking about just going.
But now they're like, well, it's been quiet enough. Why don't we just move in and finish out the Roche?
Oh, they're kind of going, but they're not committing fully.
Secret finally, okay, they come around. They're like, are you doing our Roche? Are you doing our Roche?
Oh, boy.
And they're going to scare Liquid back.
Arrow connects on Microphone. 5 second arrow.
He's locked there up on the high ground. Though. Yeah, they can't do anything about it.
Roshan is so low. Neither team can really leave it. They know the other team will get it.
Tamaman goes in and goes right out. Eventually, Arteezy moves into Liquid territory here. He's going to be forced to step on the side, but needs to avoid the trouble of Fata, and will do so. Oh, here comes Secret. Look at this. They're wrapping around on the left side.
Oh, Light Healer, you do not want to fight against
Shadow
the Terrorblade.
Comes out. They're waiting.
Oh,
they're forcing
for the
Liquid forward.
Oh, Radiant's top tower is pushing under in the creep wave. I mean, Liquid have to defend eventually.
They
Look
are corralled
the
together now down the staircase, and they're just heading for the pit.
I mean, they're zoned out, and they don't even have TP on one of them as well.
They're just like, let's go in and let's go. They're going to get it. They're going to get the rush. They got it. They grab it up. Arteezy steps in, like, excuse me, what is happening over here? Makes a move in, and he could quickly go down. Pops up the Lotus Orb, is barely able to timber chain away. Meanwhile, Mind Control going to get blasted right there with a fire blast and with the chain. Coming out from Puppy. Buybacks are going to be forced here from Liquid now. And Kuro, who steps inside the pit, goes for a stomp. Will be able to get it off. The Pylon Dyer's there waiting for him.
Oh, does he get him? He can't wake up.
Oh, he's got that splitter. Timbersaw is going to be crumbled apart.
And Envy, in fact, manages to die on bottom lane as well. At the same time, he was trying to rat. He got the tier 3 tower down. And yeah, he does get brought down. Alchemist and his buddies managed to get him killed, so that was way better for Liquid than I ever expected it would be.
Oh yeah.
Secret played so scared in that fight. I thought they would just send in some TB illusions, take the fight, just rush at them with the mana burn illusions, but playing pretty cautiously,
so
say
much
the
respect
least.
Between the two.
Oh, definitely.
They know that, like, with one foul play, the other team is going to be privy to be able to jump on, capitalize, and just kind of punish them on the other side. But Matamaman still gets to support this Aegis now. And Liquid now feeling like they can be able to dictate the pace a little bit. Think about moving on forward here and clearing out a fresh tier 1.
I mean, Liquid would have to be pretty confident after that fight. They were like, okay, I guess they don't want to fight us. We'll just take Roche, and they get it. Look at Matamaman just feeling like a boss going.
Annihilation's a bit late, and then they'll loft in a way.
Arrow not gonna connect to anyone.
Secret Soul obviously feeling like they can take a comfortable fight here. Matamaman slowed down.
Okay,
toggles and gets forced. And that will be the separation.
Man, this really hurts the timing. Wow, he blinks in a Puppy.
Puppy's dead. He goes down.
Alright.
Good snipe there from Matamaman, utilizing his blink.
And Secret, they're just being picked apart right now by Liquid. I thought they were so far ahead. They were in fact 12,000 ahead when they were so scared to take the fight around Roshan. Feels like they should be the ones controlling, not Liquid, but Matamaman, like a boss, just goes.
And now they're going for a tier 2, and it's Liquid just kind of waiting back. Arrow, not going to be there. The two mighty cores begin to chisel down this structure. It is bloodlusted though, so.
There's no real way to defend it as you have Lich dead already. If you commit, then Chronosphere is going to come down. At this point, you don't fight, but when everyone is alive, I think Secret, they just need to do some pep talk and, you know, get the let's do it mentality.
Yeah, obviously Envy is a huge factor in these fights too. The one fight now that's been able to be going Liquid's way, Envy made a call to kind of move for that backdoor play and was probably caught pretty much away from his team and on his own. So
yeah,
this time they definitely need to kind of make sure they're all in unison with what they want to do.
I think they just need to take the fight straight up because Terrorblade, he works so well against Lifestealer. Lifestealer doesn't play very well against a hero that has such a low max HP and so high armor. Lifestealer does no damage to Terrorblade at all. He even has the evasion now as well. So they should definitely be trying to go for the conflict here.
Liquid take one. And now they're going for the tier 2 in this bottom lane here. A jump in from the top man. Tries to go for Puppy once again. Puppy going to be forced back. Moonlight Shadow comes out. And Arteezy walks in. Pops out the Shivas here. Both Fada and the top man. Waiting back in behind. They're going to get in with the burst. And that will be the Aegis here. Now Liquid, are they going to want to re-engage for this one? Trying to bail on the top of Man. We maul Fonta, gets a set up for Bulba. Bulba going to be forced to go into a Yules. Arteezy just is out the Shockwave. Bulba's going to make it to the low ground, but Liquid now looking to disengage and step back and away. Jerix will take the high road here while Fonta goes low. Him and Mind Control and the rest of Liquid will make their hasty escape, but it's end up running into Bulba, where they'll take down there. Yeah. Jerix still kind of deep out here, but looks like he will not be spotted, and Liquid make it away with only a Bulba takedown.
Wow, that is really impressive for them, and he couldn't blink away due to the Radiance. He leapt away, but the blink never really got off cooldown as the Radiance from Alchemist just chased him down. And another good fight for Liquid. I'm just ever amazed by the way this game is going. It feels like, I don't know, I'm at that point when I don't understand Dota anymore, Envy. I don't know. Feels very awkward.
With Liquid taking a win here, tiebreakers could be upon us. The money continues to crumble in. The advancement of this net worth on the L continues to get higher and higher.
Yeah, and right now, with all these items they picked up and Alchemist getting gear capped, now they actually should be scared. They have a reason to be scared because Alchemist got so much armor. Can't just burst him down with a Terrorblade damage anymore.
Fada casually walks in there, and then it's an Insta-Chrono setup. They're looking for the target, but it's not going to be easily spotted. Fada totally withdraws from this one as Envy runs in. Kuro pops out the Time Slitter, but it's not going to be able to get connection. So Secret make their move. Arteezy joins our Eternal Envy in making a catch. It's only going to be for Kuro, it looks like, as the others make a hasty escape. Jerix, though, still lingering around. He's been spotted, and as you said, he has a gem, which will quickly get snagged up by Secret.
Secret managed to take that fight in the end, even though it was a hard commitment on the Alchemist that looked like it could backfire at first. Still get it. Lifestealer and Void get out without getting killed, and of course Alchemist as well made his way out. It's not too bad of a fight, just three supports dying.
That, but it is Liquid moving in and really not doing any sort of objective pressure. Tier 3 still stands pretty strong, and
they have an awkward high ground push.
Yeah.
For them, it's very hard, and it goes back to what we were saying when we cast TNC earlier. It's one of those high commitment kind of drafts. You have to just go in and take the fight. You're not going to be able to just siege slowly, and that's where Secret have an advantage. Terrorblade is great at taking down the enemy base, and Metamorphosis just came off cooldown.
And here comes trouble from Secret. Liquid will begin their approach to try to slow down this wave. Shouldn't be too much pressure. They have plenty of wave clear to work with here between the Acid Spray and the Elder Titan, of course. Even Fade Bolt helps quite a bit.
Yeah, they're just slowly setting up some vision as well. They clear the top creep wave, and then Puppy sets up a ward there. And they're just trying to get that chokehold on Liquid.
And be able to do it in good time here. And I don't know if they want to stall all the way out for the Roche, but that seems to be when they tend to run into trouble. So I wonder if it's something that they consider and try to make a push, as they have the better sieging team before Roche is even a consideration.
Yeah, I think that would have been a good play. Oh, right now, Secret, they want to make a play with the Invis.
Matama Man, he's farming the Ancients nearby.
Oh, so close. And the Courier as well, holding out on that Mount Everest.
Golden OD. Hi there.
They find Matumba.
And they also see the Courier, and it gets taken down quickly there from Envy on the side. He puts full force on for Matumba Man. Him and Arteezy going to be able to take him down. Matumba Man's out. Quick sender for Fata. He's going to be low, and he quickly tries to retreat. If they lose him too, this could be bad for Liquid.
Yeah, definitely. Kuro's got to be the one to fall, though, as they focus down on him.
They settle for it. Cost of the machine and everything, but that is going to be Matumba Man out for nearly a minute without a buyback.
Yeah, that is really harsh for them. Nice quick reactions though from Envy there, getting the Courier as well as targeting down on the Lifesteer. And that was sort of what I expected earlier. The Lifesteer works so poorly against Terrorblade in teamfights. You can see how he can't even run away.
Buyback comes out from Kuro. Mind Control in position on the left hand side with a Chrono just in case.
They saw him with the arrow, and they're not even going to push there. They're just saying, okay, we're going to play this one safe. We forced out your buyback. You're going to be happy with that.
Pull all the way up and off, and Secret can take some farm on the way out, and then probably look to scout Roche as the timer's underway. But for them, it is a longer timer, about 2.5 minutes till they'll even be back.
Yeah, I'm a little bit surprised, by the way, by Matumba Man's itemization. Maybe he's going for the upgraded Orchid. Could be that, because he knows there's evasion on the Terrorblade already, and still he goes for a Crystallis. But of course, if he goes for the Orchid, upgrades that, then you have the guaranteed hit as well.
So, oh, you mean the Bloodthorn?
The Bloodthorn.
Upgrade. Yeah. could be very nice. We'll see if it's the
I haven't seen a single Bloodthorn, in fact, in this entire group stage yet.
I haven't either, now that I think about it.
I have not seen any of our games, at least.
Yeah.
Maybe outside of them.
Yeah, there's like three other games usually simultaneously, I'm sure.
There's
probably
been a lot of Dota.
Here comes Liquid, smoked up. They look to scope out the pit, but they will see nothing's there, and nothing will be there for at least another minute and a half.
DD Lifestealer, though.
Ooh,
that is so strong.
A stolen Moonlight Shadow that Jerix happened to snag, now going to be used.
Great scan, though. They also saw that they're in the neighborhood.
Yes, they did.
Oh, Matumba Man, he wants to jump someone with this.
He's thinking about it. Holds it back, though.
Oh,
even my control. Look at him hanging up on the high ground.
On the board.
Spotted, quickly gets down. Secret look to make their move and hope to get the Stasis Void out of the picture, but they can't quite follow it up. Kuro zones them back with the Spirit, and Secret do
both
not
teams
risk
backing
it.
Out, playing it a little bit safe. Of course, Liquid will have to back off soon as mid lane is pushing in. You have to do something about it. Just sit here forever and Secret know this. They're going to smoke up, though.
All right, Secret. Let's see. They can move in, take a big fight. Take a big push in the base.
Oh, Kuroki, not again.
They shot those Raxes. Oh, man. No chance at all. Arteezy spots Kuro, and just as fast as he sees him, he gets him killed. And he sees Jerix there, too, who's looking to sidestep the shotguns, but he has nowhere to run. He has to run right through him, but he is going to be able to make it back. Gets Telekinesis off, and Matumba there to assist. The Pi's moving in. Gets the two, gets the three. Multi-Blaster coming on forward. They're going to be able to get the finish. Look at the army come out from Envy. Going to work on the racks now. No glyph seems to be popped yet. There, it's going to be popped now for the damage, man. It has been done. Arteezy being the gatekeeper, forcing the rest of Liquid back it away, but Envy does the real job here and quickly is the demo man.
He's already top, he's going for this base.
He's running that way, the tier 3 only had half of its life. Liquid on the verge of not even being contended for tiebreakers and going right into the lower bracket, joining Secret there.
One more kill as well, getting the lifesteal there, really big pickoff.
He is out for over a minute without a buyback, and they're not done yet. Arteezy looking for more. He is gatekeeper of the Fountain of Liquid as he heads right back and out, not allowing him to go anywhere. While Envy does the dirty work, the Megas are out, and I think Secret are going to block out Liquid from making it into the upper bracket.
Secret with a beautiful comeback here after what has been a very, very hard few days. And look at that smile on their faces.
They needed that.
They
like, needed
finally
that.
We got some good Dota done.
They needed a series like that for a day. It was just long overdue for Secret, but the